So I don't mind telling you I'm scared to death. The doctor's going in on the 25th. It's the same thing my daddy had. Thank God they caught it fast. But if something should happen, stop it sometime and say it.
Okay, good morning, everybody. How are you doing out there? All right, we have a great crowd. I can tell there's a great excitement in the air, and we're excited about that because this is our 80th Bandera Electric Cooperative annual meeting. So give yourself a round of applause for that. 80 years. Man, that's a long time. Okay, as we do with our annual meetings, we're going to start the service with an invocation, and to do that today, we have our District 4 Director, Jeremy Diller.
Good morning. Good morning. Before I do the invocation, I just wanted to say something about Michael Edwards. Can you wave, Michael? So Michael, about 2 years ago, I don't know if he was going to make it. So he was really sick, and the Lord miraculously healed him. He was roping cattle, I think, a couple weeks ago out in New Mexico. I didn't know if he was going to make it, honestly. And he's a great board member and a great president. I'm just so thankful for the Lord that he healed him. So with that, I'd like to. So if you don't mind, let's pray. Lord God, we thank you for bringing us together today, and I thank you for each person here today, and I thank you that you care for each person here and about every aspect of their life. And Lord, we ask you to bless our communities represented here. We pray for those that are going through difficult times and hardships, and I pray your comfort and presence with them. And Lord, we ask for divine guidance and wisdom in the work of the Bandera Electric Cooperative. And we ask for divine protection over all of our employees this year. May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord look with favor on you and give you peace. I pray this in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you very much, Jeremy. Okay, so now we'd like you to stand, please, for the posting of the colors. This year, the colors will once again be presented by the all-volunteer Fort Sam Houston Memorial Services Detachment. This detachment was established in 1991 to perform the duty at Fort Sam Houston National Cemetery to assure our nation's military veterans receive a fitting tribute they so richly deserve. Now, after the posting of the colors, we'll do the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by the national anthem performed by Aaron Patterson. And now, the posting of the colors. To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now, our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight O'er the ramparts we watched was so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Thank you, and please be seated. Good morning, everyone. My name is John Padolino, and I am the General Counsel and Chief Administrative Officer of Bandera Electric Cooperative, and it's my pleasure to be here today. It's the cooperative's 80th annual meeting, and it's my first annual meeting as your General Counsel. I thought to break the ice, I'd maybe tell a lawyer joke or two to kind of get everybody loosened up this morning. So last night I went on the internet to look for some lawyer jokes, and I thought, you know, they just all make us lawyers sound so bad. So I decided I'd tell a joke about an engineer instead. This engineer, his name is Bill, and he's a manager of an electric co-op, served a long career running the electric co-op, and had kids, grandkids, an integral part of his community. And finally, one day, he finally went over the rainbow and found himself walking up to the pearly gates. And he sees St. Peter there, and St. Peter acknowledges him and looks at his clipboard and points to the stairs, and these fiery stairs right there. And Bill's thinking, why do I have to go down the fiery stairs? And St. Peter says, well, you're on the list. You gotta go down there. And Bill thought, well, I did everything right. I was a good member of my church, I coached my kids' sports teams, I did everything I was supposed to do to get through the pearly gates, and now they're telling me I have to go down these stairs. And as he does what, you know, he's a rule follower, and he does what he says, so he doesn't argue with St. Peter, and he starts heading down the stairs, and it's hot, it's dingy, it's dirty, and then he's working his way down 7 levels of stairs. And he's thinking, you know, we really got to fix up this place. And he meets the head honcho, the devil. And the devil's like, Bill, welcome. We've never had an engineer here. We're so glad you could join us. And Bill says, well, I'd really like to fix up the place. The first thing you need here is electricity. And so, you know, over the months, Bill goes about stringing wires, all very 7 levels. He installs electricity throughout hell. And they put in elevators and escalators, they put in running water, water fountains, even have air conditioning. So good that word finally gets up to heaven, and God hears about this and goes, what's going on? You know, what's with all these improvements down in hell? And he hears, well, they got an engineer down there, and God says, no way, all engineers come to heaven. Well, this one went down to hell, and God says, you know, I need to call the devil and straighten this out, I need to talk to him. And so God picks up the phone and calls the devil, and the devil says, oh, thanks for sending Bill down here. He's great. Elevators, escalators, running water, air conditioning. We really love Bill. And God's just perplexed, and he goes, that's a mistake. He should be up here in heaven. And they really start arguing. I mean, they're yelling back and forth. God's saying, send him back up here. The devil's saying, no, I won't. And God says, you send him back up here, or I'm going to sue you. And the devil says, after a big chuckle, oh yeah? Where are you going to get a lawyer? So Well, welcome. We'll get into the business part of this meeting now. And let me talk about quorum. The bylaws say, in case the total number of members of the co-op exceed 1,000, then at least 150 of the members present in person or represented by mail-in ballot shall constitute a quorum for the transaction of business at all meetings of the members. And if you just look around, we have way more than 150. So I have been advised that there is a quorum present. Therefore, I declare this meeting officially open. At this time, I would like to welcome your chair of the BEC Board of Directors, Michael Edwards, to preside over today's annual meeting.
Thank you, John. Pretty good joke for an attorney. I'm going to spare you a joke today. That one was so good. Thank you for attending BEC's 80th annual meeting. At this time, I'd like to introduce our board of directors, beginning with Jerry Word, District 1. Representing District 2, we have Fran Lau. From District 3 is Douglas or Rob Sandridge. Rob is also the vice chairman of the board. Jeremy Diller is our District 4 director. Serving as District 5 director is Jerry Pierce. Richard or Dick Ernst represents District 6 as our director. And Zeta Alvarado is our director from District 7. Kurt Solis represents District 9 and also serves as our board treasurer and secretary. Again, I'm Michael Edwards, representing District 8, and it's my honor to serve as the chairman of the board for Bandera Electric Cooperative. I now call upon the board secretary, Kurt Solis, to read the notice of the meeting and proof of mailing.
Thank you, Michael. I, Kurt Solis, being duly sworn on oath, depose and say that I am the secretary treasurer of the board of directors of the Bandera Electric Cooperative, herein called, referred to as the cooperative. On the 26th day of April 2019, a notice of the annual meeting taking place on this day, May 18, 2019, was mailed to each member of the cooperative by depositing each notice with United States Mail, and that the above and foregoing is true and correct copy of said notice of said meeting as aforementioned. The next order of business is a reading of the minutes of the annual meeting held May 19, 2018. And since copies of these minutes were distributed to members through the annual report during registration, I would like to entertain a motion to dispense with the reading of the minutes if the membership so wishes. So can I have a motion? A second, please. We have several seconds. All in favor with aye.
Aye.
Any opposed, same sign. The motion carries and is approved. And now I have the privilege of introducing to you Mr. Bill Hetherington, your Chief Executive Officer of Bandera Electric. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Kurt. It's reassuring to know that engineers go to heaven. Good morning. My name is Bill Hetherington, and I'm the General Manager and CEO of Bandera Electric, and I also want to welcome you to the 80th annual meeting of the Bandera Electric Cooperative. This morning, I'd also like to introduce and welcome Steve Dyer, who is joining us as a visitor from LCRA, who is our power supplier. On this Armed Forces Day, I'd like to recognize all of those who served our country and the armed forces. So I'd ask that they please stand, all of our veterans, please stand, and we thank you for your service. Twenty 2018 was a year that could best be characterized as high growth. We saw a 10% growth in our electric membership, a 9.6% growth in our electric energy sales, and along with the growth that we saw in our energy sector, we saw an astronomical 376% growth of our high-speed internet service, which is now generating more than $2 million in annual revenue. Yay. These factors all contributed to make 2018 a financially strong year, with net margins approaching $8 million. 2018 was also a very capital-intense year. To accommodate this growth and improve our reliability of the grid, we completed major projects, including the rebuilding of our Lakey Utopia transmission line and the addition of a new dedicated distribution feed between Bandera and Medina City. We have been able to accommodate this growth and keep our reliability good while keeping our electric rates stable. In fact, the BEC residential electric rate continues to be below the average residential cost of electricity statewide. And just so your reference, Bandera is the bottom curve there, the low one. I think what is really remarkable is with regard to electric reliability, I'm thrilled to announce that BEC's reliability was ranked first among electric cooperatives in the state of Texas. This information was provided to us by the U.S. Energy Information Administration, and with more than 400 co-ops across the country reporting, Bandera Electric Cooperative ranked 10th best with total outage minutes per customer and 6th best with respect to a number of outages per customer nationwide. Achieving this milestone, of course, could not be possible without the hard work and dedication of our employees. So I'd like to thank all of our employees, BEC employees who are here today, for their hard work and dedication. Last summer, some of our linemen competed in a statewide competition showcasing their skills at line work, and I'm proud to say that Bandera Electric Cooperative Line Crew team finished first placed overall in the state of Texas. Benjamin Franklin once noted that without continuous progress in growth, words as achievement, success, and improvement have no meaning. Based on the context, the achievements that Bandera Electric Cooperative has made in 2018 were quite substantial. Progress is defined as moving forward toward a destination. But what is that destination? Is it low electric rates, high reliability, great customer service, all of the above? From the very beginning of this organization, our mission has always been to improve the quality of life of our members. The term quality of life and happiness are often viewed as synonymous and are tightly connected to engagement and interaction, whether it is with friends, family, or participating in community events or programs. A recent study conducted by Cigna, a nationwide health insurer, found that nearly half of all Americans feel isolated and lonely at times. In the report, Douglas Nemechek, MD, Cigna's chief medical officer for behavioral health, said that the findings of the study suggest that the problem has reached an epidemic proportion, rivaling the risk to health given by tobacco. Our theme this year is about connecting with community, and we want all of our members to feel connected and engaged. So we're introducing the BEC Foundation. This foundation will be the vehicle in which Bandera Electric Cooperative strengthens its bonds to the communities we serve. I'd like to now show you a short video explaining what the BEC Foundation is all about.
For more than 80 years, BEC members have trusted their electric cooperative to keep the lights on in our part of the Texas Hill Country. But that's not the only way we power up our service area. In addition to providing reliable electricity, BEC has a legacy of charitable giving that makes our communities better places to live. As the population in the BEC service territory steadily increases, there's more demand placed on organizations that serve various needs in our communities.
And while the name is new, BEC support of charities and nonprofits in our communities is not. We've been doing it for decades. Last year, we supported more than 80 different organizations, serving thousands of individuals in our community.
The BEC Foundation's primary areas of support include education, health, safety, community service projects, environmental issues, and disaster relief.
One such organization is Triple H Equitherapy, whose approach is truly unique. They use horses to help children and adults with disabilities, improving the quality of life in our community.
The horses provide wonderful therapeutic activities for individuals with all kinds of challenges and special needs.
I would really like to thank Bandera Electric for allowing veterans like myself the ability to participate in these programs and allow us the opportunity to heal.
There's people that do struggle, and for God to give us the opportunity to work with a faith-based company that's so close to us. I think a lot of people think it's the blessing to the clients, but it's really a blessing to volunteers too when they get to come and serve.
If you're a nonprofit organization or know of one that would like to apply for a BEC Foundation grant, visit our website for more information. The BEC Foundation is supported and managed by BEC, so overhead costs are low and more of your contribution goes directly to help our community. How can you get involved? Here are three easy ways. Round up your BEC monthly statement to the next dollar amount. This small amount can really add up if all of the thousands of BEC members join in. Sign up on our website or call the BEC office for help. You can also make a tax-deductible gift of any amount to the BEC Foundation. Mail it in with your next payment or drop it off at any of our four locations. Make the BEC Foundation your charity on Amazon Smile. That way, every time you shop, Amazon will donate a portion of your eligible purchases to our foundation.
We are so delighted that we have a great partner in Bandera Electric Foundation, and we are so thankful that you donate through them because they make a big impact on us.
Friendly, hardworking, with an independent spirit. That's what makes the communities of the BEC service area among the best you'll find in Texas.
I would strongly encourage all of you to support the BEC Foundation because all of the money raised by the foundation comes back to our community.
Sometimes you need a little help to get the most out of life.
We measure our community's character by how we assist those in need.
Last year, we promoted a program with our national association called Who Powers You? It was a program whereby individuals could nominate those who provided inspiration through their acts and deeds. Out of the thousands nominated nationwide, I'm very pleased to announce that a member of our community was recognized for his efforts. His name is Hunter Beaton, and along with his mother Paula, they operate a nonprofit organization called Bags and Backpacks, supporting foster kids. I would now like to show a brief video about Hunter.
Picked up our first child. He really had nothing at all. But then I went on and moved on because if I was secure that the baby was healthy or getting the needs that was needed for at the age, I started getting a little bit more comfortable. And little did I know in the background, my son was observing how each one was coming into our home with nothing. Or a trash bag, which didn't even cross my mind.
I'm Hunter Beaton. I am 18 years old as of January, and I live in Burney, Texas, which is just 30 miles north of San Antonio. When I was 8 years old, I was kind of blessed with an experience that occurred with my younger cousin. So when I was in town and we were just getting home, and my parents received a call, and they received a call from a CPS caseworker. They said, "Hey, my cousin, but your nephew was currently placed in the foster care system, and we don't have any place for him. Would you be willing to take him?" And they've already done the work for it.
My name's Jimmy Chittum. We are currently standing in the warehouse at Flying Circle Gear in Burney, Texas. Hunter walks through the door and he says, "I need bags for kids moving between foster situations because they're using trash bags." And I had got stuck with a bunch of extra camouflage bags that I didn't have anybody to sell to. So he started running around and told everybody he could that he's got these bags, and everybody went, "Awesome." And next thing you know, I'm shipping out hundreds, if not thousands, of these bags to different foster agencies and child protective agencies across the state.
It all started with my Eagle Scout project. And when I was thinking of a project to do, usually you would think of doing a building project or something that's helping with the community, maybe like building a bridge or building benches. And I had those ideas in my mind, but there was always something in the back of my mind that was like, I think I could do something a little bit unconventional. And I decided to supply bags full of supplies for foster children that are going into a new home.
To be able to see an opportunity like this to help children who are so vulnerable at this stage of their lives entering into that situation, it was great. And you know, their effort to be able to take a small idea and have it grow to impact so many of thousands of children out there is phenomenal.
Six bags only a month later, and I only gave 100 bags. What is it gonna be like in a year? What is it gonna be like in 2 years? Then they're gonna be back to trash bags where they can't afford or they can't really produce their own bags to give to these kids. So I thought, I think I feel this calling to help out a little bit more.
To support the outstanding efforts of Paul and Hunter Beaton, the BEC Foundation would like to donate $2,500 to the Bags and Backpacks organization. We truly appreciate their efforts to serve these children, especially during National Foster Care Month. And we want to wish your organization continued success. Frontier Times Museum provides numerous enriching educational opportunities for Bandera County schools free of charge. So the BASAV Foundation would also like, on this occasion, to donate $5,000 to the Frontier Times Museum. The check up here momentarily. There's the check. It's all about logistics. In addition, we'd like to recognize the Golden Age Center in Comfort, which offers a variety of services to support persons 55 and older in need of hot, nutritious meals served at the center or delivered to their home, along with educational programs focused on health, wellness, and safety. Please join me in congratulating the Comfort Golden Age Center with another $5,000 donation for the important work they do. Thank you very much. The grants presented today are funds generated through our Roundup campaign and from our BEC Foundation Charitable Golf Tournament. I encourage all of you to consider rounding up your bill to the next highest dollar to support our foundation. Its only average is about $6 a year, but with all of us helping, it can make a big difference. Thank you very much. This concludes the CEO report.
Thank you, Bill. I would like to call your attention to the annual report, which was provided to all members today. Our annual report contains the management and financial reports for 2018. Any questions regarding the 2018 annual report or other business-related matters will be addressed after the annual meeting adjourns.
It is now time for the election results. According to the bylaws, the business affairs of the cooperative are managed by a board of 9 directors, each representing one of 9 districts. Each year, 3 board members are elected for a 3-year term to fill vacancies caused by the expiration of the incumbent's term of office. This year, the membership will be electing the directors for districts 7, 8, and 9. The bylaws permit director candidates to be nominated by petition. If agreed to by the incumbent directors are placed into nomination along with any members nominated by petition. There are no petition candidates nominated this year. Therefore, the incumbent directors shall become the official candidates. The following persons are placed in nominations as the official candidates. District 7, Zita Alvarado. District 8, Michael Edwards. District 9, Kurt Solis. This year, survey and ballot systems tabulated the votes received by Friday's May 17, 2019, 11 a.m. deadline. The final tabulation of votes include all electronic, phone, and mail-in and proxy ballots. I will now read the report regarding the final tally of votes for each candidate. Zita Alvarado with 2,099 votes, Michael Edwards with 2,059 votes, and Kurt Solis with 2,007 votes. I would entertain a motion to approve the vote. And a second, numerous seconds, and all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? None. And the motion passes. At this time, I would like to ask if there is any unfinished business to be presented. And hearing none, I will entertain a motion for adjournment of the meeting. So moved, and a second? Got a second? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Very well. This meeting is now adjourned. Thank you.
Okay, folks, the meeting is adjourned, but we still have a couple of unfinished things of business to take care of. First, I'd like you to stand once again for the retiring of the colors by the Fort Sam Houston Memorial Services Detachment. And then please remain seated afterwards for a couple of important announcements, including our prize giveaways. But now, the retiring of the colors. One moment, please. and the retiring of the colors will commence. Everybody can have a seat, relax. We have a few more things to go through, and this is a part of the annual meeting that everybody looks forward to every year. So we're gonna be giving away more than $7,500 in prizes this year, including a zero-turn tractor that we're gonna have more details on in a few minutes. And another thing that we like for you to do to win, for an opportunity to win one of $100 additional gift cards, rather, is to fill out a survey that we're going to be sending everybody on Monday, okay? Fill out the survey, return it, and we're going to have a drawing for two $100 gift cards. That's your chance to win one of those $100 gift cards, extra added value for you by BEC. So the first thing we're going to do is draw for the grand prize first, and we're going to place it in an envelope, and then we'll wait and see whose lucky number that is and name at the end of the prize drawings. So Jennifer here is going to do that, and she's going to place it in the ticket, in the envelope, rather, and then we'll announce it at the end of the prizes. Pick the lucky one. All right, so we have it in the envelope, and it won't take too long before we get to that, so please be patient and remain seated. And now we're going to give away our first prize for... All right, we're going to start off big right now. It's an Apple iPad with Wi-Fi capability and 32 gigabits in silver color. And that one is going to... All right, 350072, 350072. All right, so another thing we like to do is if you can pick up your prizes afterwards. If you'll bring your ticket up front, we'll document that, and then we'll give you your prizes afterwards. Do we have a winner over there, sir? Come on down. Congratulations. Everybody give this man a round of applause for being the first winner. Okay, now for our second prize. It's a Home Depot gift card valued at $50, and we want to thank LCRA for donating this today. Thank you very much. So the winner for this one is 0029, 0029. Do we have a 0029 out there? Let's see. Okay, we have a winner. As a matter of fact, if you'll hold on to your ticket, you can come by afterwards and let's match it to this one here, and you can claim your prize afterwards. All right, so no need to walk up. For our next prize, we have a 2019 Lenovo Flex 11. This is a 2-in-1 laptop with 11.6 touchscreen. So this is one of your more advanced laptops that we're going to be giving away at the BEC 80th annual meeting. And this winning ticket goes to 0140, 350140. Raise your hand if this is your ticket, please. Try it again, 350140. Winner, winner, we have chicken dinner. We have a winner. There you go. We'll get it together, folks. All right, so congratulations on that. That's a very nice touchscreen laptop. Moving on to the next prize. Another Home Depot gift card valued at $50, again presented by our friends at LCRA. And the winning ticket for this one is 0061, 0061. Okay, we have a winner, 0061 for the Home Depot gift card. Next up, an Apple Watch. This is a Series 3 with a nice display. This one is in a space gray color. Everybody needs an Apple Watch these days. And this is going to go to 0171, 0171. Okay, I want to make sure we have the right number. Don't want to go Steve Harvey on us now, okay? Let's see, next. Someone got that. Thank you very much. All right, the next prize is this it? Another Home Depot card? Okay. Another Home Depot card presented by LCRA, and this one goes to 0191. 0191. All right. Fantastic. Congratulations. Home improvements coming your way. Okay. Now we have the Nest Learning Thermostat. I'm not sure the value of this, but I believe it's somewhere in the 200-plus range. It's a nice device to get you on your way to smart home technology. And this one goes to 0006, 0006. Okay, great. Congratulations on that. Couple that with your BEC fiber and you have a powerful device right there for smart home technology. Next up, Home Depot gift card, valued at $50 again by LCRA. And this one goes to 0143, 0143. Four, three. 0143. Okay, going once, going twice, one more time for 0143. Okay, we're going to move on to somebody else. This is for the $50 Home Depot gift card. 9845. Again, you must be present to win 9845 for the Home Depot gift card. There you go, sir. Congratulations. Donated by LCRA. Okay, next up, we have a second-generation Amazon Echo. This is a smart speaker with Alexa technology. And this one goes to 0115, 0115. Okay, we'll try it again, 0115. Must be present to win. Going once, going twice. Okay, we're going to move on to somebody else. Okay, the next winning number is 0088, 0088 for the Amazon Echo. What? Nobody wants this prize? Okay, folks, have your tickets ready so we can match numbers. All right, so we have a winning number out there. Fantastic. Congratulations on the Amazon Echo there. All right. More prizes coming. You see right there, we have an HEB gift card for $200. That's a nice one, right? 9901 for the $200 Okay, let's make 349-9901 or 9901. 349-901. Do we have a winner? Okay, winner. Did you get that? Okay. 349-901 is the winning number. 349-901. Let's raise the hand so we make sure. Confirmation. There you go. Okay. Thank you, sir. Okay, next up we have a Ring Video doorbell and an Echo Dot, a nice smart home technology package there for you from BEC. And this one goes to 350079, 350079. Okay, I see a winner over there. Congratulations, ma'am. If you win, if you could please stand up so we can see you a little bit easier, for just to confirm that. So congratulations on that. The next prize is an iRobot, the Roomba 614. Handy to have. Handy to have. All right. So this one goes to 350012. 350012. Anybody have that out there? There you go. We'll see you nice and proud. Thank you, sir. Okay, next we have the KitchenAid Artisan Series. This is the 5-quart stand mixer in white. Very nice home appliance. And this one goes to 350087. 350087. There you go. Winner over there. Thank you, ma'am. Congratulations on that. This is a collector's item right here. This is a Texas Co-op Power 75th anniversary cutting board. Thanks to Charles and Texas Co-op Power for being here today. We appreciate that. And that one is going to ticket number 349939. 349939. Oh, okay. Congratulations. Okay, it's going to be some competition for this one. This is a 40-inch TV, smart LED, with Roku TV capability on it. Okay, so this number goes to, this prize goes to 349-921, 349-921. Okay, let's try it again, 349-921. Is there a winner? No? Okay. Going once. 349-921. Going twice. Okay. Must be present to win. We're going to draw another number for this 40-inch smart TV right here. And it's 349-933. 349-933. Winner. Is that you, ma'am, right there? 349-933. Congratulations on that one. Okay, another nice HEB $200 gift card. And this one goes to 349-910. 349-910. $200 HEB gift card. Stand up, please. All right, fantastic. Thank you for that. I just want to make confirmation. All right, thank you. Okay, next up, Home Depot gift card. This one valued at $250. $250. This one goes to 350131, 350131. Okay, we'll try it again. We have one? All right, good. Okay, there you go. Thank you. Appreciate it. Congratulations. Okay, another HEB $200 gift card. 350193. Does anybody have that winning ticket out there? There you go, in the green shirt. Thank you. Congratulations. Okay, another Home Depot gift card valued at $250. 349874 is the winning numbers. Where we got? Got that? Okay, that was quick. Thank you. Congratulations. HEB gift card, $200. 349-891, 349-891. Congratulations, sir. Okay.
Is this the grand prize?
Oh, you can hear the ooze out there. Special thanks to DAS and PLC, JPLC, thank you very much for their donation of this. This zero-turn tractor is valued at over $5,000, probably closer to $6,000. You see it on display right over here. It's a very nice piece of machinery. And now, that first ticket that we pulled in the beginning, we're going to announce the name right now, the number right now, and again, must be present to win. So here we go. All right, before we draw this, I just want to take a quick moment to thank really all the BEC employees for their hard work in putting this annual meeting together. I think they did a great job today. I mean, everything from the prizes to the catering to the displays. You know, we're here working for you, and we thank you for being our members. So here's the winning ticket, 349-862, 349-862. Wow, look at this right here. Our DPS officer. Thank you for being a member and thank you for serving. Folks, don't forget to fill out your survey. We're still going to give away two $100 gift cards. If you return it, you'll be in a drawing to win one of those two $100 gift cards. Thank you very much. Y'all drive home safely. Thank you and God bless.